You're watching Reality Check on the night when the Shiv Sena's Uddhav Thackeray has been sworn in as the 18th Chief Minister of Maharashtra. At a glittering ceremony in Mumbai Shivaji Park, there is Uddhav taking the stand and being sworn in as Chief Minister. A turn of events that some would say signals the end of ideology in Indian politics. Just consider the images from the swearing-in. Side by side, there you will see on the screen, bitter political rivals now coming together to seize power. Manohar Joshi there of the Shiv Sena next to Kamal Nath of the Congress. Uddhav Thackeray next to Chagan Bhujbal, who's now with the NCP. Sharad Pawar flanked by leaders like Manohar Joshi, all coming together. Let's actually consider for a moment all of these contrasts reflected in the social media timeline of Supriya Sule, the NCP leader. Look at that. November 23rd, she says in a WhatsApp status, "Who do you trust in life? Never felt so cheated in my life. Defended him, loved him. Look what I get in return." This is in response to her betrayal, as she said, by Ajit Pawar, and then that other image of her with Ajit Pawar. There she is now saying, welcoming Rashmi Thackeray, the wife of Uddhav Thackeray. More images that she's put up on screen includes her with Aditya Thackeray and Rohit Pawar, her nephew. Even going to the extent of saying that she misses Bala Sahab and Ma Sahab, which is Mrs. Bala Sahab Thackeray. And of course, look at this image. Who would have thought? Sonia Gandhi with senior Shiv Sena leaders like Subhash Desai and Gajanan Kartikar, who came to visit her. Uddhav Thackeray, of course, seeking Sharad Pawar's blessing, which set him off on this path towards chief ministership. And even this, Indira Gandhi's image, images of Indira Gandhi and Bal Thackeray, in fact, on posters put up by the Shiv Sena, in a sense, recalling that legacy of the Congress's role in propelling the Shiv Sena in its early years. And of course, the other striking image of what in a way reflects the end, quote unquote, of ideology. There is Ajit Pawar being sworn in by Devendra Fadnavis, or with Devendra Fadnavis, just about 5 or 6 days ago. And there is Ajit Pawar on stage at Uddhav Thackeray's swearing in next to Praful Patel. Both instances, Deputy Chief Minister with Devendra Fadnavis, and by all accounts, just 5 days later, he's going to be Deputy Chief Ministership under this new government. So, what does this mean then for the politics of ideology, of the politics of principle? I put this to Prithviraj Chavan, senior Congress leader and former Chief Minister, earlier today. Let's listen. But let me ask you this, that in the event that Ajit Pawar does return to this government, perhaps with a big post like Deputy Chief Minister, would you be comfortable with that? Because remember, it was under your watch as Chief Minister that the entire inquiry began into the irrigation scam.
No, I think I'm not sure whether he's going to be in the cabinet or not. We'll discuss that when he actually comes in the cabinet. At the moment, the two members from the NCP are likely to be Mr. Jayant Patil and Mr. Chagan Bhujbal.
Right. But you know, that is on the point of principle, on the point of anti-corruption, as it were. But on the point of ideology, Mr. Chavan, how would you even today justify your alliance? You're actually getting up on stage, not you personally, but your ministers getting up on stage and being sworn in with the leader of a party whose ideology is diametrically opposed to your own. I mean, the Shiv Sena is the original, in some ways, even the more hardline party of Hindutva.
No, that is your interpretation. I think Shiv Sena members have taken oath of the constitution. And every tenet of the constitution will be adhered to. That is the understanding on which we have come together. And as long as they uphold the principles enshrined in the constitution,
yes.
I mean, where is the issue about ideology?
Well, the
in
fact
the past,
is,
yes, when Mr. Balasaheb Thackeray was the leader of the party. They had a particular point of view. But let us look at today's Shiv Sena. It's a popular party. And I think we will not, none of us will sacrifice our ideology.
No, but
and
Mr. Chavan.
The basis of this alliance is the Indian constitution, particularly the preamble of the Indian constitution.
But Mr. Chavan, the fact is you talk of Balasaheb Thackeray, even until very recently, the Shiv Sena has come out very strongly in support of the Babri demolition. Sanjay Raut himself has said that the mosque could be demolished in 17 minutes. Why is it taking 17 years to build a temple? The Samna has come out with an editorial that actually endorses Nathuram Godse, calls him a patriot. Huge uproar in parliament, rightly so, over Sadhvi Pragya supporting or championing Godse. The Sena too has not that long ago spoken in support of him.
Well, we have a long time. We have 5 years to discuss the ideological issues. Mm. But one thing is clear. On the Ram Mandir, the highest court in the land had pronounced a verdict. Mm. I think that is behind us now. I think we come together to solve the questions before the state of Maharashtra, people of Maharashtra, we will take a stand. And there is going to be a coordination committee which will meet regularly. And so any contentious issue that is raised will be sorted out in the coordination committee.
But tell me, Mr. Chavan, surely there is some discomfiture within the Congress over this, because your top leadership, neither Sonia Gandhi nor Rahul Gandhi nor Dr. Manmohan Singh are attending.
No, but that is not, it's not necessary that for every swearing in, the top leadership attend. It is a coalition government of three parties. Mr. Uddhav Thackeray is taking oath as the chief minister. Our members will be part of the cabinet. Mm. I mean, I don't think you should read too much into who is attending or who is not attending. But we are very happy that we have been able to prevent an unscrupulous group of people like the BJP. Mm. And you saw what happened in the last 4 or 5 days, last week.
Yes.
How they grab power at any cost. So the real face of BJP has come out in the open, right from the Prime Minister, who woke up the President at 5 o'clock in the morning to revoke the President's rule. Amit Shah, who complimented Mr. Ajit Pawar, if you're raising issues about him, both Mr. Amit Shah and Mr. Prime Minister Modi complimented him, particularly after the vicious campaign that he carried out during the Vidhan Sabha and the Lok Sabha election. So the unscrupulousness of this alliance has come out before
but
the country.
Mr. Chavan,
that is precisely the reason why we do not want another 5 years of a BJP government.
But Mr. Chavan, that was my initial question to you, that someone who was part of that, as you describe it, unscrupulous act, Ajit Pawar, has been welcomed back into the fold. What is to prevent there being a repeat of a similar act of being stabbed in the back?
Point is the BJP's Fadnavis, the tragic and unsuccessful attempt by Mr. Devendra Fadnavis, supported by Mr. Prime Minister Modi and Amit Shah, of course, which come unstuck, could not have happened without the active participation of Mr. Ajit Pawar, who supposedly either carried the entire party with him or broke the party, split the party. We don't know what exactly happened. Mm. But that unholy alliance or unholy government would not have come into being without Mr. Ajit Pawar.
Yes.
Now, Mr. Ajit Pawar, whether he joins as a member of the NCP is for them to decide. Mm. And he was my colleague for 4 years that I was a chief minister. And I think there are, as the government has already announced, that there are inquiries going against him. And let us not judge him till he is found guilty.
But in
let's
that
wait
context,
for the outcome of the inquiry.
But in that context,
this government is particularly keen to.
Yes, but in the context you just described, the fact that he was very much part of this whole coup against you and the cases, do you think that it would be unfortunate for him to be resurrected in this manner?
Well, I think I don't get to make that decision. I think this is a decision by the NCP party leader, Mr. Sharad Pawar. I think if he sees value in his becoming part of the government, I think he probably might recommend his name to the chief minister.
Right.
But let us wait. It's been made very clear by him a little earlier that he will not be taking oath today.
All right, so Prithviraj Chavan there with some strong words for Ajit Pawar, who he says was responsible for that unholy alliance between the BJP and the NCP. What does all this portend now for this coalition of contradictions? Joining us tonight on the show, we have with us Sanjay Jha, spokesperson of the Congress Party, Clyde Krastow, spokesperson of the NCP, Niranjan Shetty, spokesperson of the BJP, Sanjay Gupta, spokesperson of the Shiv Sena, and last but not the least, Neeja Chaudhary, senior journalist, here with us. So, Neeja Chaudhary, I know we've been talking about how the fact that ideology is ending in Indian politics, but when we saw those striking contrasts there on stage today at the swearing-in, do you really think that this can hold?
That is the million-dollar question. Will it hold? For how long it will hold? You know, they've done a pretty detailed exercise for the Shiv Sena to say we swear by the Constitution and particularly the preamble of the Constitution, which has the word secular
in it. Yes.
So it has climbed down from the positions it has held.
Right.
And Sonia Gandhi has climbed down from the positions the Congress has held towards the Sena in the past. Even though they talk about Ram Rao Adik being the actual architect of the Sena's, author of the Sena's constitution years ago. But, you know, ground sentiment dictates the politics and the stance and the position of political parties, and in this case, the entire Aghadi coalition.
And you believe that the ground sentiment is backing this?
Ground sentiment means Congress,
Aghadi,
NCP and the Sena coming together.
Right.
And if all the three have to come together, then they've got to find a common minimum denominator around which they function. And that is the common minimum program. He cannot be taking an aggressive Hindutva line, Uddhav Thackeray, nor can Sonia Gandhi be insisting on a hard secular line. There won't be any government otherwise.
Right.
So there's a middle path somewhere that they're striking.
Okay, Sanjay Gupta joining us. Sanjay Gupta, firstly, congratulations. Aapko badhai ho. Aapke leader, Mukhya Mantri, ban gaye hain. Lekin common agenda, kaafi, jaise aapki jo baat ho rahi hai, end of ideology, aapne jo dilute kiya hai is common agenda mein se, khas kar ye Shiv Sena ke liye. So the language of the common agenda says, alliance partners commit to uphold secular values enshrined in the constitution. All parties will take a joint view on contentious issues linked to secular fabric of the nation. Two seculars just in the first paragraph of this joint agenda. So, Sanjay Gupta ji, mera seedha seedha aapse sawal hai. Kya Shiv Sena apne aap ko ek secular party maanti hai?
Dekhi ji, sabse pehle main aapko ye batana chahunga ki secularism, Hindutva and Hindu rashtra, ye tino hi ek baat hai. Secularism means सर्वधर्म संभाव
और सेक्युलरिज्म और हिंदू राष्ट्र एक ही बात है,
यही है।
ये तो एक नया, ये तो आप कहीं और ही इसको ले गए।
देखिए राम मंदिर बनाने के लिए, धारा 370 हटाने के लिए इन दो शब्दों का ऐसा इजाद किया गया था जिसको कांग्रेस जो नहीं करना चाहती थी, ताकि बीजेपी के साथ हमारे गठबंधन की सरकार बन सके और हम राम मंदिर बनवा सके और धारा 370 हटवा सके। हिंदुत्व और हिंदू राष्ट्र का मतलब किसी धर्म के खिलाफ नहीं है। हिंदुत्व और हिंदू राष्ट्र का मतलब यही है कि जो भी इस देश का नागरिक है, जो किसी भी धर्म का है, किसी भी जाति का है, वो हमारा अपना है। और अगर कोई इस देश में रह करके
तो एक ऐसा डेफिनेशन है हिंदू राष्ट्र का,
वो हमारा दुश्मन
है। जो मैं पहली बार सुन रहा हूँ कि हिंदू राष्ट्र नाउ मीन्स ऑल रिलीजियंस, देन व्हाई कॉल इट, देन हाउ इज इट हिंदू राष्ट्र? आपने मेरे लेकिन सवाल का जवाब नहीं दिया कि क्या शिवसेना आज से अपने आप को एक सेक्युलर पार्टी मानती है, यस और नो?
देखिए, मैंने आपको एक सीधा सा जवाब दिया कि सेक्युलरिज्म, हिंदू राष्ट्र और हिंदुत्व, ये तीनों एक बात है, सिर्फ समझने की बात है। जिस दिन भी आप इसकी गहराई में जाएंगे तो आपको पता चलेगा कि तीनों एक ही बात है, सिर्फ राम मंदिर मुद्दे को बनाने के लिए,
दिस एक्चुअली
सारी सूत्र को हटाने के लिए, हिंदुओं को अपनी तरफ करने के लिए इन शब्दों का इजाद किया गया और इसकी डेफिनेशन बनाई गई।
संजय झा, आई एम नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस, मे बी संजय झा कैन हेल्प अस आउट। संजय झा, डिड दैट मेक सेंस टू यू? Do you, based on what he's just said, he's saying Hindu Rashtra, this is the ally, you're in government with them. He's saying Hindu Rashtra is the same thing as secularism.
Vasu, let me just stick to what the common minimum program actually states.
Okay.
Now, let me give you one headline here. Even if you look at the BJP's party constitution, It says that they are secular. Now, secular is in the constitution and incorporated as a key, I would say, a quintessential part of the Indian constitution. It depends upon political parties. How do they practice that?
But do you consider, Sanjay, uh-huh. We're not on the definition of secularism. Do you consider Shiv Sena a secular party?
Well, let me give you two examples here. The Shiv Sena, Mr. Uddhav Thackeray is on record. And the Shiv Sena, I'm glad, actually took the stance that they said that lynching violence, which actually has happened under Mr. Narendra Modi's government, several incidents, many people have been killed brutally. And Shiv Sena said that lynching is not Hindutva. So, you know, I do believe that you are seeing at the moment a shifting terrain where people are recognizing that India is multicultural, India is pluralistic in nature, and that cannot be destroyed just because of political party.
Hold on, Sanjay.
Of being,
if you're, of being, but you, Sanjay, you know, the thing is, Sanjay, ideology. You can't cherry pick, because the Shiv Sena, you may have found one example where the Shiv Sena says that lynching is not Hinduism, but the Shiv Sena, as I just asked Prithviraj Chavan, has also called Godse a patriot.
Well, I'm not going to deny that if you look at the history, the Shiv Sena and the BJP were ideological partners for the same reason. They had a more hardline view. And that is precisely what has changed. And let me be very upfront here with you.
Okay.
The reason why it took a bit of time, Vasu, to put this common minimum program together, to focus on the key element, because you were right, you asked me this question several times on your program, that how is it that two parties which are at core incompatible in ideology are coming together.
Okay,
and, you know, we recognize this difference, but we have also reconciled to the reality that we need to bridge this gap to be able to give Maharashtra a good government.
Okay.
And therefore, from tomorrow, it's to governance we're going to be focused on.
Well, Clyde Crasto, you know, you can keep talking of governance, but the fact is that these are the views that this party brings to the table. And then on the other hand, you have your ideology. How is this? How will you justify this to your own voters? Where on one minute you say I stand on principle X, I'll fight for it, and then on the other hand,
I'll tell you something.
You ally with a party like the. Can I just ask you the same question, Clyde? Do you consider the Shiv Sena a secular party? Let me ask you straight question.
Is it
communal?
I have a straight answer. I'll give an answer to that. I'd like to jog back your memory a little, and I'm sure the people who are listening to us, our viewers, I'd like to tell them that, remember one thing, the Shiv Sena was formed on this one particular idea that they wanted to do something for the Marathi Manus, for the people of Maharashtra.
That was a long time ago,
Clyde. They came together.
We're all aware of the history.
Can I come?
We're aware of the history.
No, I have something to say, Vasu. If you allow me to speak, I'm not going to talk just history. I'm just connecting it to the present.
Okay? Yes.
So that's what the ideology was.
Yes.
But when they aligned with the BJP,
they
somewhere changed their track a little bit and went towards the Hindutva ideology.
Mm-hmm.
Well, now they've gone back to the idea of working for the people of Maharashtra again. And what's wrong in that if they're coming back to the ideology of, or the idea of working for the people of Maharashtra? And you look at the common minimum program, like Sanjay Jha was saying, it took a little time because we were working on ironing out the same very issue that you're talking about. And today we have a common minimum program that's completely worked on the betterment of the people of Maharashtra.
But you just heard our dear panelist from the Shiv Sena, he's saying secularism for him means Hindu Rashtra. What have they given up? I mean, how do you ever reconcile those two things? But anyway, let me go across to Niranjan.
The preamble says, you know, that upholding the secular values are enshrined in the constitution.
Okay.
They are talking about it, right?
Well, either it's the Rashtra of the constitution or it's Hindu Rashtra, my friend. You can't have both at the same time. But anyway, Niranjan Shetty, so what is wrong? What is wrong if your former ally, the tiger, has been tamed, they have given up their Hindutva spots, and they have now embraced secularism, they have embraced constitutional values? What is wrong with that?
Vasu, I think through your channel, there are a lot of revelations going on for today. I have been seeing Clyde or Mr. Sanjay Jha, right from the, I think, the birth of the Shiv Sena, have been accused of Hindutva or right wing. Today, I also thank both of them that they have tamed the tigers, probably, you know, congratulate them that they have tamed the tiger. to accept the secular values.
You're provoking the tiger. You're trying to, by complimenting them. You're provoking the tiger. You're provoking the tiger.
चेठी जी आप बताइए क्या हिंदुत्व और हिंदू राष्ट्र किसी धर्म के खिलाफ है? ये सिर्फ उसी के खिलाफ देना चाहता
हूँ. मैं धन्यवाद देना चाहता हूँ कि आपने उन सेक्युलर वैल्यूज को अपहोल्ड किया जो संजय झा जी बता रहे थे कि बीजेपी के इसमें भी मैनिफेस्टो में सेक्युलर है, जो हम तो निरंतर मानते हैं. लेकिन आज मैं धन्यवाद देना चाहता हूँ कि 1960 में जब आपका जन्म हुआ, अब तक इनको, इनके नवाब मलिक जी को या संजय झा जी को या कांग्रेस को पता नहीं चला कि आप सेक्युलर हो और सेक्युलर वैल्यूज को अपहोल्ड कर दो. मैं ये इसलिए कह रहा हूँ कि आज उनको समझ आई. आपका जो दृष्टिकोण है उनको समझ में आया.
ओके ओके,
हाँ बस यही कह रहा हूँ मैं यही कह रहा हूँ. और इसके बावजूद भी उस टाइगर को उन्होंने इस प्रकार को मान्य करने के लिए बाध्य कर दिया.
ओके,
इसीलिए मैंने इन दोनों को धन्यवाद दिया.
वासु, आई जस्ट लाइक टू टेल निरंजन जी, इफ द चेंज इज फॉर द गुड, आई थिंक यू शुड एक्सेप्ट इट एंड बी हैप्पी.
ही इज हैप्पी, ही इज कांग्रेचुलेटिंग यू, बट नीजा.
Yeah, I already congratulated.
No, but I think but you see, sad somewhere that is, you know,
not at
that
all.
Talking
not
about
all.
Taming that, you know, they tried their best, but they couldn't do that.
Tell me, how do I present it? Now, I saw Clyde Vivabin, I remember that.
Okay.
N number Nidia, of times.
You think that, I mean, look, there's a lot of good chemistry, optics, all that. But again, remember that quite apart from ideology, power sharing, only 6 people sworn in. This has now become the norm. Because if you swear everybody in the first round, you straight away have bagawat. So there's that problem as well.
I think with that, they have thought through very, very carefully. Mm. Uddhav Thackeray, these two, Eknath Shinde, Subhash Desai, very close to him. Everybody knew this was going to happen. So also Chagan Bhujbal and...
You think so?
Yeah, I think this has been... And now the main thing is going to be Ajit Pawar. And this shows the weak point of this alliance. Mm. You know, Sharad Pawar may be the master craftsman who people think will, you know, everything will depend on him, how long he wants this alliance to last. But actually the cards are going to be in the hands of Ajit Pawar, because he still has 20 to 25 MLAs loyal to him in the party.
And Ajit Pawar, put the graphics up, Nija, irrigation scam accused Ajit Pawar. So there is that as well. He brings that whole legacy
though
to the
that
table.
That has been closed. So one good thing not, that happened of his, you know, switch over not, and switch back.
Well, not all.
That was a one gain.
Not all, according to the CBSE, Eddie. But you know, how would you justify that? So, how Sanjay Gupta ji, ye aap kaise justify karenge ki Ajit Pawar, jinke khilaf itne cases hain, wo aapke upmukhyamantri hone wale hain? Chagan Bhujbal, cabinet mein aaj unki shapath grahan hui, unke khilaf wo bail par hain. महाराष्ट्र सदन स्कैम में
देखिए, हमारे देश के अंदर बहुत बार ऐसा होता है कि जब इन्वेस्टिगेटिंग एजेंसीज अपनी इन्वेस्टिगेशन सही से नहीं करती, और कई बार वो कर भी नहीं पाती, तो बहुत बार ऐसा होता है कि जब अदालतों के अंदर उसकी इन्वेस्टिगेशन होती है, किसी निष्कर्ष पर जब इन्वेस्टिगेटिंग एजेंसीज पहुंचती हैं, तो उसके बाद फिर लोअर कोर्ट में जब उसको प्रोड्यूस किया जाता है,
आप,
तो कई बार वो भी सही फैसले देती है. और उन्हीं के फैसलों को
आज शिवसेना अजीत पवार को डिफेंड कर रही है, ये तो कमाल हो गया. मतलब as I said, this is a day of many firsts.
हमारे देश में जो प्रोसीजर है उस प्रोसीजर के अनुसार ये काम अदालतों का है.
संजय गुप्ता जी, आउटस्टैंडिंग. आई बी नॉट वी आर नॉट लाफिंग एट यू, डोंट टेक इट द रॉन्ग वे. आप करो, आप पर ऊपर नहीं हंसना है. ये पॉलिटिकल, ये एक जो पॉलिटिकल मतलब
हमारे देश में
पूरा काया पलट जो हो गया है.
कानूनन, एक चीज बता देता हूँ. कानूनन हमारे देश में किसी भी
निरंजन शेट्टी यू आर लाफिंग बट यू नो, it seems like there is almost a stampede to give Ajit Pawar a clean chit. You were first. The BJP was the first to do that.
We are not giving the clean chit. We just described the rules as per our law.
Let Niranjan Shetty speak. I just turned the mirror
to show them their face, so that they can also see what exactly is going on.
Few days back,
Mr. Sanjay Rao. Sanjay Raut was trying to show us the mirror.
No,
now it's your turn.
Okay. Clyde. Clyde. Yes, Clyde. Yeah, yeah. Clyde.
Yeah, you know, quickly I'll tell you, you know what, Vasu, we kept saying that all the allegations that they were making towards Mr. Ajit Pawar were untrue. That's what we kept saying, okay? The, 2014, the platform
but Clyde,
to win that election
he betrayed,
was to
okay,
talk
forget,
about Ajit
okay,
Pawar.
Okay, for a minute, forget but the allegations. No, he betrayed you. He betrayed. He walked out on you.
Yeah, that, you
you're welcoming him back.
No, so why not? He's our leader. Well, mistakes happen. He accepted his mistake. He came back.
Wow.
Okay, but
amazing.
what about the BJP? They went
well,
to
tell
town
you,
to accuse him.
I can tell you one thing
okay,
because we're out of time.
With him.
I can tell you one thing we're out of time because of all this.
In
the
fact,
task
you know, in
of
fact,
all
in
of
fact,
you as spokespersons has become very difficult.
To the people of Maharashtra
I, lying. You have my deepest, you have my deepest sympathies and my deepest respect because all of you now will have to really kind of be creative in how you go about defending this new arrangement. But anyway, we'll have to leave it there. We wish the new government in Maharashtra all the best. But we're out of time on Reality Check. Thanks for joining. Thanks for watching. Good night.